We're going to showcase a little bit today about SolarWinds applications on Microsoft Azure from within their marketplace.
I love that our page for SolarWinds products that are available in the marketplace is so long that you have to actually scroll. And many of these are products that our customers have relied on for years. And three of these even have been in here for some time.
Right. But yeah, tell you a bit more information about obviously what's going on. But the key thing that I'm going to want to do, because I know I want to install it, I'm going to click Create. And immediately, it's going to instantiate the configuration or the baseline configuration, the key things that the script needs to know in order to go and deploy Server and Application Monitor. In fact, that's my first screen. So first of all, it's giving me a suggested name, Sam Server. I'm going to create a little password here.
Password 123.
Don't tell everybody. I'm going to choose this subscription into which I wish to install this particular application. I'm going to use my MSDN account. Resource group. Now, this is a great thing because obviously with a resource group on Azure, you can put in all your components so that if you are doing dev test, it makes it just that much easier for management control and at the end of the day, if you need to do some cleanup as well. So I've entered my baseline information, and of course, I just click OK, and it's going to take me to the next pane. So it's going to, in this case, look at infrastructure information. So, you know, we are deploying it in an infrastructure as a service model. So we're actually installing it on top of Windows Server. So once I'm in here, again, I can select a username, give myself another password, if I can remember how to type.
Password 345.
Shush. You're telling all my secrets. Anyway. Azure actually comes back and makes sure that I have a strong password. That's one of the nice things. You know, some of us don't like strong passwords, but obviously that's a key thing to be thinking about.
We should all like strong passwords.
We should all like strong passwords.
Or at least long passwords.
Yes.
More actually, passphrases backed with MFA.
There we go. One of the things, you know, we do recommend or provide recommendations on what virtual machine size you want to run this on, but you can see from here and you have a huge selection and choice in exactly what you want to deploy it on. And of course, all these have been tested out with working with Microsoft. So all these applications, once they do appear in the marketplace, are actually Azure certified. It's been tested, it's been validated, and nothing gets up in there without that certification process taking place. So we're in our settings pane, so from here I can select which operating system, Windows Server 2016 or Windows Server 2019, I want to put it on. I can select whether I want a standard or in fact a standard hard drive or a standard SSD drive.
Yep.
It's going to give me a bit more performance. And then if I have a Windows license, otherwise that's going to get consumed through the pricing on the back end. Network settings, we'll just choose the defaults, but obviously you have some choices there as well. The last thing it's going to come up with is just to, do you want to support scalability engines? And so that's just a way to be able to extend out the monitoring breadth and scale of the Orion platform, which is the baseline for SAM. One of the things we just announced earlier this year was our support of Azure SQL Database. And so that's obviously one of Microsoft's PaaS services for SQL. You can instantiate your own Microsoft SQL as an IaaS instance as well. But you know, for speed and performance, we're going to go with the Azure SQL Database.
Speed, performance, and actually cost.
There you go. If you're interested in looking at the ARM template, then you can certainly open it up as I have here. You can download it. You can change it for your own particular environment if you wish to use automation on the back end. Obviously, I'll leave you to play around with that.
Or, I don't know, save that somewhere so that you can go back in time and say, how is this originally configured?
Yeah. Actually, you can add that to your library so that you can deploy it again in the exact same fashion.
Yeah. Unfortunately, passwords are not in there, but that's a separate issue. So I'm going to put my phone number. I'm not really going to put my phone number in. Patrick, I'll put yours. So anyway, there's my contact information, terms of use, and literally talking about instantiating, create, off we go. And it's off to the races. Immediately, Azure is leveraging that ARM template, is out taking the software image and putting it into the subscription and the resource group that I've just specified. And then just in a few more minutes, it will be complete. And off we can go and start using our new SAM deployment.